Which is best for you, the Blue G9 or the Blue Vivo XL4? Well, in this video, we're going to find out. Hi everyone, this is Kevin here, coming at you with my comparison video of the Blue G9 versus the Blue Vivo XL4. Now, the Blue G9 is very new to the market. It literally came out like several days ago, so it was launched in mid-May of 2019, and the Blue Vivo XL4 came out in December of 2018. So the Blue Vivo XL4 is about 6 months old to the market, with the Blue G9 being very new to the market. Now, you can buy both of these devices right now on Amazon, factory unlocked, well, GSM unlocked, so you can use these with any GSM carrier, such as AT&T or T-Mobile, and Cricket and Metro by T-Mobile. Now, currently, the Blue G9 is available for $179.99, and the Blue Vivo XL4 is available for $129.99. Now, with the launch of the Blue G9, the price of the Blue Vivo XL4 was lowered by $30, so originally, the Blue Vivo XL4 was available for around $150, but again, as I mentioned, once the Blue G9 came out, they did lower the price of the Blue Vivo XL4 by 30 bucks. And it makes sense because if this was still around $150, then these would only be $30 apart, and that would make these very close in price. Now, the Blue G9 features a 6.3-inch display coming in at 720p, and the Blue Vivo XL4 features a 6.2-inch display, which is also 720p. The display on the Blue G9 has a 19:9 aspect ratio, with the Blue Vivo XL4 having a display with an 18:9 aspect ratio. So a little bit of a taller display with the Blue G9. Now, looking at both of these devices, there are certainly some big differences. The biggest difference here are the notches on the top. So with the Blue G9, we have kind of a more modern teardrop notch with just the front-facing camera there and the earpiece a little bit higher up above it. Now with the Blue Vivo XL4, we have a notch that's definitely a lot larger and similar to the style on the iPhone XS. Now in this notch, we have the front-facing flash, the earpiece, and the front-facing camera. Now, there is no front-facing flash, of course, in the Blue G9. Personally, I think a front-facing flash is kind of a gimmick. I know it's a feature that I barely use myself, so I certainly don't miss not having it on the Blue G9. I'd much rather have this design here with the teardrop notch, since it's a lot less intrusive, and the notch really doesn't get in the way of anything. And the same can't really be said with the Blue Vivo XL4, because the notch really does get in the way of a lot of notification icons and things like that, and you can just see how much smaller it is on the Blue G9. So let me know down in the comment section below which notch you prefer, but I have a feeling you're probably going to prefer the notch on the Blue G9. Otherwise though, both devices have very good looking and clear displays, so they're super sharp, super clear. The camera might not show all that off, but they really do look great. So if you're really into watching movies or browsing the web or even reading books on your phone, you're going to be very happy with the displays on both of these devices. So if the notch isn't a big deal to you, then I would say that the displays here on these two phones are about equal. Now they both have a decently large size lip on the bottom, and that's kind of a compromise that you have to accept with budget smartphones. You know, you're not going to get the most amazing design here with no bezels or anything. I would say the fact that both phones have notches is pretty impressive on its own, considering the price range that they're in. And especially with the Blue G9, I just really like this design. It looks very modern, and it's very consistent with the various leaders in this price range from other brands. Now, both devices feature 13-megapixel front-facing cameras. For my testing, I've noticed that the front-facing camera on the Blue G9 is a little bit better. Now, of course, you do have, like I said, that front-facing flash with the Blue Vivo XL4, but I think it's a gimmick, and I think the better quality with the front-facing camera on the Blue G9 really does make up for it not having a front-facing flash. Now internally, the Blue G9 has 64 gigabytes of storage, with the ability to expand that with a microSD card, and the Blue Vivo XL4 has half the amount of storage with 32 gigabytes. Now we do still have SD card expansion, so that's great, but still, out of the box here, internally, we're getting half the amount of internal storage with the Blue Vivo XL4, so that's kind of disappointing. 32GB isn't bad by any means, but it is incredible that for the $180 price tag, we do get 64GB of internal storage with the Blue G9. Now, neither of these two devices have wireless charging. In fact, with the Blue Vivo XL4, it would be impossible for it to have wireless charging because you can't wirelessly charge through metal, which is the material that's on the backside of this phone. Now, both devices do have fingerprint sensors, and they both have face unlock. So you can see here are the fingerprint sensors. I'll do a quick demo here of that. So we'll do the Blue G9 first. So you can see super quick with that fingerprint sensor, great location, right where my index finger normally sits. So that's really fantastic. And we'll try it with the Blue Vivo XL4. Again, super quick, almost quicker on the Blue Vivo XL4, but I mean, both are really fast, so I wouldn't be disappointed with the speed. Now, we do have some big differences with the cameras on the back here. So with the Blue G9, we have a 13-megapixel Sony IMX 214 sensor, which can actually be switched over to a 52-megapixel mode with 4x interpolation done in the software. So the original photo is still 13 megapixels, but the software is able to multiply those megapixels by 4 to give you a comparable image with 52 megapixels. So I don't know for sure if it's a gimmick or not. I need to do a little bit more testing with that, but I'll tell you what, this device does not have bad cameras by any means. And the secondary camera here is 2 megapixels. Now with the Blue Vivo XL4, we also have a 13 megapixel main camera. You can go check out the review I've done for the Blue Vivo XL4. I've taken a lot of photos with the camera here and it's all featured in that review video. But essentially, you are getting a good quality camera with the Blue Vivo XL4. So just because the camera's better on the Blue G9 doesn't mean that the camera's bad on the Blue Vivo XL4. And you do get a secondary camera that is 2 megapixels. And both devices allow you to take photos in bokeh mode, which is similar to portrait mode that's found on the iPhones. Now, as far as RAM goes, you're getting 4GB of RAM with the Blue G9 and 3GB of RAM with the Blue Vivo XL4. So you do get an extra gigabyte of RAM with the Blue G9, which I really appreciate and find to be quite awesome. Now, here's the really interesting part. Both devices have the same processor, so they both have the MediaTek Helio P22. Now, it's a good processor. It's not a bad processor at all. I would have expected, though, something a little bit better with the Blue G9, considering its price tag of $179.99. But for $129.99, the MediaTek Helio P22 is a great deal for the Blue Vivo XL4. Now, don't get me wrong. Even though I'm a little disappointed that that's the same processor in the Blue G9, it's not bad. I mean, you're gonna have a good experience overall. But I do find it to be very interesting that both phones do have the same processor, because the processor is one of the most expensive components that is included in the device. So since the processors are the same, really all you're gaining here is the extra gigabyte of RAM that will increase performance here. And then I suppose you can count having 64 gigabytes of storage as an additional bonus, but that's not really gonna have an impact on performance. Now, video recording resolution for these two devices does max out at 1080p at 30 frames per second. Certainly not bad at all for a budget device. Both devices have the same 4000 milliamp hour internal battery. And for the software, we're getting Android 9 Pie out of the box with the Blue G9. And the Blue Vivo XL4 has Android 8.0 Oreo. And I'll tell you what, if you think the Blue Vivo XL4 will be updated to Pie, then I'll be really impressed with that prediction, because I can't imagine it will be updated to Pie. I think we're going to be stuck with Oreo on here for life. But that's another compromise that you have to make with budget devices. A lot of the times the manufacturers do not set aside funds to hire a team to get the latest software on their various devices. So pretty much whatever you're getting when the device ships is what you're gonna get for life. So I'm guessing that the Blue G9 will probably be with Android 9 Pie forever as well. It probably won't be updated to Android Q. And if it does, then that's great. But I'm just saying that when you buy these phones, expect to have the software that they both run forever. Now, with that being said, I don't think Oreo is really that bad. You're gonna get good performance here. It's gonna work well. The device itself is very well optimized. So that's the nice thing about Blue. So, you know, they don't always do software updates, but the software they do put on their phones is great. So it's very well optimized. The cameras are optimized in the best way they can be with the software, so they nail the software the first time so that they don't have to do updates later on. Okay, now that we've compared the specifications of these two devices, let's compare the hardware. So we already went over the displays here, so they're both 720p, 6.3 inches on the Blue G9, 6.2 inches on the Blue Vivo XL4. We have different style notches here on the top. They both have a pretty large lip on the bottom, so that's pretty much that with the front here. Now on the left side, they both have the same configuration with just the slot for the micro SD card and SIM card. On the right side, they also both have the same configuration with the volume rocker and power button. So already, there's a lot of similarities with these two phones. On the top side, on the Blue G9, there is nothing. And on the Blue Vivo XL4, we have the 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. On the bottom side, there's some big changes here. So on the Blue G9, we have the speaker, we have the microphone, we have the 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, but we also have a USB Type-C port. And that's great to see because USB-C is the future. Now at the Blue Vivo XL4, we have the microphone as well, but we do have a micro USB port. I suppose it's not the biggest deal that the Blue Vivo XL4 has a micro USB port on the bottom here, but I do love to see USB-C. Taking a look at the backside of these phones, there's also some really big differences. So the Blue G9 has this kind of cool reflective material in the back here that is a little bit lighter on the top and darker on the bottom. So a cool gradient here. Now it's certainly a fingerprint magnet, as you can see. And my fingers are not greasy. I mean, I wash my hands all the time, whenever I can. And it's not like I ate Cheetos or something greasy and then touched these phones. This is normal grease just from living my life. So just know, and it's the same thing for the Blue Vivo XL4. You're going to get grease on the back as well. So both of them are going to get greased on the back. Unfortunate to see, but it is the reality, so you better accept it. But really cool material on the back side of the Blue G9. On the Blue Vivo XL4, we have a metal back here. Now, generally, I would say metal is better, but I don't know. I mean, they both look good. I don't think having metal back here really adds much to it. That's kind of my opinion about that. Now, we do have the speakers on the back side of the Blue Vivo XL4. Of course, the camera modules on both phones, the flash, fingerprint sensor, blue logos, and the secondary blue logo as well. Now, Blue always includes a lot of goodies in the box for their phones, which I really appreciate. I wanted to show you everything that's included for both devices here. So we'll start with the Blue G9. So we have the wall adapter, which is pretty standard, a Blue branded wall adapter. So good to see. We have the USB Type-C cable for charging and data transfer. So this is kind of a cool, unique USB-C cable. It has kind of a braided chrome look to it. So yeah, USB-C right here. We have a Blue sticker that matches the box. We have Blue branded headphones. We have a SIM card removal tool. We have a clear plastic TPU case. And we have a glass screen protector. Now with the Blue Vivo XL4, we also have a clear case here. So that's cool to see. We have the micro USB cable for charging and data transfer. We have Blue headphones. We have the USB wall adapter. We have a Blue sticker that matches the box. We have a SIM card removal tool. We have a glass screen protector. And we have a second case that matches the design that's on the box. So really awesome, really unique and different that we have two cases included with the Blue Vivo XL4. Now that we've compared what's included in the box, with there definitely being quite a bit for both phones, let's do a speed test here. So we'll start by opening up the cameras in both phones. So 1, 2, 3, go. Looks like the Blue Vivo XL4 was first to pull up the camera, but it was very close in both phones. Let's open up Google Chrome in both phones. 1, 2, 3, go. Looks like the Blue Vivo XL4 was also a little quicker here. Let's go to yahoo.com. 1, 2, 3, go. It looks like the Blue G9 was quicker at starting up Yahoo. Let's go to Engadget.com. 1, 2, 3, go. Looks like the Blue Vivo XL4 is a little bit quicker in this test here. Both devices have really quick and smooth scrolling. So that's really nice. Let's go to this article. 1, 2, 3, go. Looks like the Blue G9 was quicker at starting up that article. So what's my final opinion on these phones? Well, personally, I think they're both very good choices. I also think they're very similar in speed here. Of course, we are getting an extra gigabyte of RAM with the Blue G9, But I really do wish they did include a little bit of a better processor with the G9, considering how much more money it is compared to the Blue Vivo XL4. Now, on the other hand, though, I really like the style of the Blue G9 better. I like that little teardrop notch on the top. I think that's really nice. And I don't necessarily not like the design of the Blue Vivo XL4, but I do feel like the Blue G9 does have a more modern design. So I think if I had to choose one over the other, I would go with the Blue G9. But I certainly think that the Blue Vivo XL4 is still a very good option. If you decide to go with it, I certainly don't think you'd be disappointed. Another thing to consider too is that the Blue Vivo XL4 probably will not be updated to Android Pie ever. So you'll probably be stuck with the Oreo. Now there's still a possibility that it will be updated, but I really doubt it. And with the Blue G9, we do have Android Pie on here, so it's a newer version of Android. So that's another benefit with the G9. So I'm really curious to know what you think. Which device would you go with? The Blue G9 or the Blue Vivo XL4? But I hope you enjoyed this video and found it to be helpful. This is Kevin here. Make sure to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and check out the links in the video description to see the latest pricing for these two phones. But I'll see you in the next one. Have a great day.